David, rebuttal?
Is there a doctor in the house?
Next question.
Hi, I love the first few of these, and I really good. It was, but I was wondering, earlier in the series, in one of the commentaries, we talked about an idea about gangs in New New York. And I don't know if you guys were going to follow up on that at all in a future movie, like after the fourth one comes out.
I have no recollection of that commentary, and now I'm getting nervous because I feel like there might have been a gold mine of good ideas in those commentaries that we forgot about over the years. But that is not, that I'm afraid that is not going to come up in the next two movies. So, but that's good news. That means we have material if we're brought back again.
Wait, the animators should answer the question about what it's like to animate large crowds of people in multiple scenes.
Oh, and describe the direct stage direction given to you, Peter, for the climactic scenes of the fourth DVD.
Crowds are not the most fun thing to animate. In the second movie, there's lots of crowds. And usually the script will say, like, every robot in the world has a huge dance party.
Shot which is describing every character in future drama ever appears.
That's in the fourth movie. Yeah. It's one line of dialogue. The line of dialogue is like gas, and who says it is every character in future drama.
Which we actually Peter took that upon himself to animate, and our studio in Korea after a couple of months sort of called back and said, like, are you crazy? We had to go back to the drama and see, like, wow, we either have to, like, come up with an overage or not. And David's like, well, why did you do that?
Yeah, they will write that. And I, to me, if I see that, like, if I'm going to draw a grandstand with every character, I want to make sure, you know, it's not everybody, but it's 300 faces that you will recognize. And then David will say, well, I thought you would just draw, like, 30 people. Like, in the second DVD, the 64-way split screen of everybody hating people, if you look, there's 64 different characters there, and they're all more or less celebrities in our world, including Pauly Shore. And I like that if you can freeze frame that, it looks good. It's not cheap, like they would have.
Oh, but we should mention, yes, the third one, and I assume the fourth one, will be released for the first time in Futurama history on Blu-ray. So, those 300 faces will actually be visible if you have an HDTV, so it was not all for naught.
When we said all the characters, we were really just undercounting. We were thinking, like, there was Zoidberg, and then Bender, and then that shiny guy, and, like, a couple of others. It turns out there's well over two dozen. There's lots of characters. Hi, this is definitely the first panel where I've been forced to kneel in supplication. Not that I mind considering all my voice talent idols are here, but I suppose the question that everyone wants to ask is, if these videos do well enough, do you think that you guys can get the series back on the air?
One of the great things about coming to Comic-Con, and we've done Futurama panels at Comic-Con every year since the show started, and the response has been just absolutely amazing. And we've talked to some of the Fox executives and found out that this year, this is their first Comic-Con. So we're hoping that there are some Fox executives lurking around and may see intense and large numbers of enthusiastic fans, and we'll see. We certainly want to do more Futurama movies and anything we can do. TV show, theatrical movie. Thank you. We hope so. We've got a lot more stories. We still have the meetings that David and I had 10 years ago where we schemed and thought about secrets of the Futurama universe. We haven't done them all. We still have a few secrets left.
I'd like to bring one thing up, which is that we're basically done recording all of these DVDs for the next for the foreseeable future. And we're still working at our office putting them together, but our cast members have various other projects going on, and I was wondering if we could go down the line and hear what our cast members are now up to in their spare time. We'll start with Ujin. We'll start with Katie Segal.
I'm actually working on a new series for the FX, almost Fox, for the FX network. I think I'm the longest running, except for Matt, person involved with Fox. That's what I think. But anyway, I'm on a new series on the FX network called The Sons of Anarchy. It is about the family lives of outlaw motorcycle clubs. And I play a biker. And it's a drama. It's pretty hardcore. It starts airing September 3rd on FX, and I hope you'll watch. And I'm raising three children.
Cass, what's spare time? What is that? Any other voices you're doing? Anything we should
do? Oh, I'm always doing those M&M commercials all the time. Have you ever eaten me? Uh-oh, 18, sorry.
Don't follow that. Yeah, right now, doing a show at Nickelodeon, a couple shows. Barnyard, what else? Attack of the Power Choo-Choo, the Penguins of Madagascar, Cartoon Network, I'm doing a show called Chowder, where I play the... You guys like Chowder? Well then, what else? Gears of War 2, coming out in November, baby! And, I like to watch TV.
I'm preparing for Orson, the one-man show. Get me a jury, we're calling it. That's an inside joke for the voiceover people. Hacking the Power of Juju is, we still got some episodes of that coming down the pike. I've been very fortunate to be guesting on The Simpsons a little bit. Thank you, Matt, for this upcoming season. And, of course, I've got, the commercial thing too, as all of us do. I'm still following my nose, and and knowing why you fly, we're American Airlines. Just jobbing, keeping busy, and grateful to be here. And open for more of this.